When we compare Space Marine chapters from the 42nd millennium to the 30K era, we can easily see that the Astarte legions of the past were much more diverse than what we see today. From units like the destroyer squads that were utilized by almost every legion, to the specialist units like the Keshig or the Morlocks that were unique to their own legions. This is because the Space Marines of the Great Crusade era were expected to be as a versatile fighting force as their Primarchs wanted them to be, which meant that if a Primarch had an affinity towards a certain type of warfare, it was a safe bet that he would create a specialized units to accomplish his goal. And on top of being commanded by their Primarchs, each legion had access to whatever military resource the Imperial Army had at their disposal. They didn't have the strict separation between the Space Marine chapters and the Imperial Guard regiments we see today. Instead, joint operations were carried out with legionnaires fighting side by side with normal human soldiers. The roles and missions of these Imperial Army warriors began to blend in with the tasks of the legionnaires, and pretty soon it became clear that Space Marines could accomplish the goal much faster and efficiently. One of these roles was reconnaissance work, which was better suited for the Legion scouts, whose enhanced senses could perceive and analyze the enemy's positions with better accuracy. Within the Thousand Sun Space Marine Legion, these Astartes became a specialized unit called the Hidden Ones, and they went much further than recon. And with that said, I want to welcome you guys back to another 40 Facts About the 40K Universe. I am your host, Gersh1, and today we're going to be talking about the Thousand Suns Hidden Ones. If you guys are new to the channel, we post Warhammer 40K lore videos every single day, so if you have any suggestions or questions, just ask in the comment section below. This is actually a viewer request. And then stay to the end of the video because we are going to be doing a kit bash of one of the Hidden Ones. It's really just a scout marine, but we're going to try to paint it and make it into the theme of like the Thousand Suns 30K era color scheme and stuff like that. So if you're into the hobby or want to get into the hobby, stay to the end. And if you guys enjoy our content, thank our patrons on Patreon. It is because of them that we can do this. Link in the description if you guys want to support us. If not, simply by liking and sharing these videos, it really helps out the channel. With all that said, let's get into 40 facts on the Hidden Ones. There are very few records that still exist of this unit, because the Thousand Sun Space Marine Legion turned against the Imperium of Man during the Horus Heresy. Much of the Legion's history has been destroyed or sealed off, and so not much is known about the true operations of the Hidden Ones. What Imperial savants have been able to gather is that this mysterious unit did in fact serve as a scout auxiliary force under Captain Amon in the chamber of the Legion's Order of Blindness. They performed the standard role that most scout marines are tasked with. The Hidden Ones would operate deep within hostile territory, gathering intel on the enemy's movements, set ambushes, sabotage supply lines, and destroy communication centers in daring commando raids. The Hidden Ones were experts at striking in silence. They were trained to accomplish their mission and vanish before the enemy had a chance to retaliate. What made all this possible was the use of Astarte neophytes. These were Space Marine recruits that were still in the process of transforming into full-fledged Battle Brothers. Their small size meant that they could blend in with the other Imperial Army soldiers and common citizenry, but their enhanced physical bodies made them incredible warriors. It is speculated that the natural psychic abilities of the Thousand Suns also played a big role in the Hidden Ones' incredible ability to operate behind enemy lines. Looking into the twisting strands of the Immaterium, the Hidden Ones were able to predict the movements of the enemy and remain unseen until the mission required it. They were secretly pioneering the psychic discipline of divination. Under the guidance of Amon, the Hidden Ones acted not just as a military unit, but also a diplomatic fact-finding or intelligence-gathering organization. They spied on planetary governors and other expeditionary forces during the Great Crusade. This was all done in an effort to protect the growing Imperium from the enemy within. And this information is all you'll ever get about the Hidden Ones. However, there are some within the Inquisition that believe that there was more to this unit's story than what is shared. Records exist of a Don Astarte spy that managed to infiltrate the Space Wolves chapter and become one of their schalts, a sort of bard or oral historian during the Great Crusade. His true name was Caspar Ansbach Hauser, and he traveled to Fenris under mysterious circumstances that he didn't even know about. This is because Caspar's mind was psychically reprogrammed to be completely unaware of his true missions. Accepted by the Space Wolves 3rd Grade Company, his true purpose as a sleeper agent cell was eventually discovered, and the Space Wolves believed that it was the Thousand Sun Sorcerer Amon, or possibly Magnus himself, who planted this spy amongst their ranks. However, during the events of the Fall of Prospero, it was discovered that it was actually a demon that called himself the Primordial Annihilator that had sent him to Fenris. This entire ordeal, plus the betrayal of the Thousand Sons, led many in the Imperium to speculate that perhaps the Hidden Ones were in fact a sleeper agent unit, and their spies were operational during the Horus Heresy and beyond. Much like the Alpha Legion, the Hidden Ones could still be operating amongst the Loyalist Space Marine Chapters, or any other Imperial Adepta. Whether this is true or simply a scheme by the Chaos Gods to make the Imperium more fearful and untrusting, that's up to you to decide. And those were 40 facts on the Hidden Ones. Now, what's cool about this story is that you can easily see how the successor chapter of the Thousand Sons, I should say the loyalist successor of the Thousand Sons, which is the Blood Ravens, Blood Ravens, the ones from the Dawn of War, they could essentially be Hidden Ones. So nobody within the chapter's ranks really knows that they are Thousand Sons, and they're really just sleeper agents waiting for Magnus to, you know, do whatever he wants to do, and then that entire loyalist chapter turns traitor. Now that would be a really, like, crazy theory, and it's probably not true. But if you wanted to create a chapter like that, you can. Or even if you just want to have one Space Marine who is a Hidden One and still exists in the 42nd millennium because of, like, he was placed in stasis or something, you can also do that. As a matter of fact, Casper is that person. Casper was actually placed in stasis, and he is right now under the Fang on Fenris. So his whole story is really interesting, and I'll cover it in another 40 Facts video, because he deals with, like, Bjorn the Fellhand and all this kind of stuff. But the point is that, yes, you can put him in a some type of stasis field or some type of stasis pod, and then, like, they come out now and they become neophytes or actual, like, Space Marine battle brothers of a certain chapter. And they're really just agents of Magnus, who's controlling them through the warp or something like that. But what we're going to do now is we're actually going to we're just taking a scout and painting him up as if he was a scout marine, or sorry, a hidden one. So let's do that. Here is the Scout Marine. I've owned this guy for a while now. I think it's one of the very first miniatures I ever purchased. I lost his head, probably through transportation, so I'm going to be using this head, which I'm going to show you guys. This is actually a third-party head from, I forget the company, I think it's called, like, Ravenclaw or something like that. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the hooded head just because I feel like it adds more mystique and it adds to the flavor of the lore of the Hidden Ones. Previously, I just had, like, a Space Wolf head, so that wouldn't really fit. But as you guys can see, it kind of sticks out. These heads are not really meant for scouts. They're meant for regular Space Marines. So what I have to do is somehow make the hole further back on the actual, like, body of the, or the torso of the miniature. To do that, I'm going to use a Dremel tool. I am just going to drill a hole and then push back with the Dremel tool, and hopefully it fits properly. As you guys can see, I'm trying my best not to hurt myself. Dremel tool has been one of the tools that I've used the most when it comes to kit bashing, but it is one of the most dangerous things that I've ever operated for miniatures. So just be careful if you guys use it. But as you guys can see, once I actually drill the hole, it's big enough for the head to fit and for it not to look really goofy. Now it's time to add some fast drying putty around the head to make it blend better with the model. And then it's time to paint. First, I'm going to use gray for the cloth bits of the miniature. This is his clothing. And then I'm going to be using some black to paint the straps, boots, and the actual sniper rifle. And then finally, I'm going to paint it with some red for the armor bits. Now, because the model is primed yellow, I need to prime the head with yellow and then paint a little bit of the cape to make sure that the entire thing is uniform in one color. Otherwise, the head is still going to stand out from the cloth bit, and they're supposed to be connected because he's wearing, like, a hood. And now it's time to add my camel pattern on the cloak. To do this, it's just a simple design, it's almost like painting little clouds, and then you just paint a lot of them of different colors. I am using like three different shades of red, and all I'm doing is I'm taking that red that I showed you from before, mixing it with blank and mixing it with white to get like three or four different hues of red. And after dry brushing and washing the model with the Nolan oil, this is the finished piece. And this is the finished model. I gotta be honest with you guys, I think it looks like trash. It has a red cloak, like a camel cloak, as if he is trying to camouflage in some type of like lava world or something like that. That's not even the bad part about this model. The bad part is the fact that I didn't strip the paint before painting a second coat. So this is a model where I'm painting on top of paint that has been sitting there for a really long time. I knew I wouldn't have enough time to strip the paint, so I decided to just spray paint over it. I regret that now. For entertainment purposes, I'm going to say that I knew that. And the reason that I did that is just because I wanted to have a teaching moment. But in reality, I was just like running short on time. If you ever want to strip paint from a model, all you have to do is get some rubbing alcohol, or there is a product called Simple Green here in the States. If you're in the States, dip that model in there for like 2 hours, take it out, and then rub it with a toothbrush, and the paint should come off. If not, what ends up happening is that you get zero details from the model. You could actually see it in this model with the gun. The sniper rifle is really, really lumpy, and that's because underneath the paint that I just added, there's more paint, and the details are gone. So I guess it's kind of a fail, but at the same time, it's a teaching moment. You could still use the camel pattern with anything else. And also, I was painting this with like four other models. I will recommend that if you guys are painting individual characters, take two at most. Don't ever try to do like four or five models all at once, because you end up just half-assing one of them or half-assing two of them. But expect those videos in the future. Those models came out a whole lot better. I'll show you guys the Ethereal, the Chaos Lord, and the Exalted Champion. Those guys came out pretty badass, but you'll see them either this weekend or next week. But yeah. If you guys have suggestions for any other topics of 40K that you guys would like us to cover, please let me know what it is in the comment section below. I'll either try to create a lore video for you guys, or I'll create one of these videos where I also try to paint a little model. Thank you guys so much for listening, and I will talk to you tomorrow. This was Gersh One with One Mind Syndicate signing out. Oh, if you could put my freedom back.